السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على عبد الله ورسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah Almighty refers to Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام as a Khalil. And Allah Almighty has also taken another from His messengers as a Khalil. That was none other than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So it is important for me to know what is the meaning of this word or this term or this name Khalil.
وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا.
Beautiful. Allah has taken Ibrahim as a Khalil. A Khalil is the highest level of friendship. It's not just a friend. We say, this guy is my chummy. That's what we say, right? This guy is my friend. Oh, he's a buddy of mine. These are all terms you and I use. Okay? But when Allah Almighty says that this person is upon the highest level of friendship with me, please pause for a moment to think of what is being said. This is Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, the Lord of the worlds, the one who made you, is actually saying, here is my friend. I have taken him as a friend. And not any ordinary friend, the highest level of friendship. So, I want to be part of those who are also loved by Allah. Allah will test you, and He will test you again, negative upon negative upon negative, according to the dunya and the worldly understanding, but in the eyes of Allah, every negative is only the door of the biggest positive. The bigger the negative in terms of worldly understanding, the greater the positive in the connection with Allah, if you are to process it in the correct way. Allah takes your health away and you say, Alhamdulillahi ala kulli hal. That's friendship with Allah. Allah takes your wealth away and you say, Alhamdulillahi ala kulli hal. That is the friendship with Allah. Allah takes your family members away. You say, Alhamdulillahi ala kulli hal. That is friendship with Allah. Allah is in control. He made me. He created me. He will decide what will happen to me, whether I like it or not. And I'm still happy with it. That's a friendship. That's what happened to Ibrahim alayhi salam. That's what happened to Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was an ummah. Allah calls him a nation on his own.
Inna Ibrahima kana ummatan qanitan lillahi hanifa.
Allah speaks about Ibrahim alayhi salam, describing him as an ummah. But how many people followed him? Nobody. Very few. A little handful. That's what happened. A massive Nabi of Allah, a friend of Allah. Nobody believed in his message besides a handful, literally a handful. His nephew Lut accepted his message. Allah says, فَآمَنَ لَهُ لُوتُ. By name, Allah says, that young boy accepted the message of this uncle of his, Ibrahim. Did you know Lut alayhi salam was a nephew of Ibrahim alayhi salam? And his wife accepted the message. Later on, it grew a little bit more. Very few people. But you and I are sitting here in this place. I think it's called Kareha. Am I right? Did I get it right? We used to know it as Utenaik, mashallah. But we need to get used to the new names, inshallah. How I remember Kareha is in Arabic language, it means disliked. Something disliked. But no problem. This is not Arabic. So it means something that is loved by the will of Allah. My brothers, my sisters, let me explain. When Allah tests you, you need to love that test. Today we are seated here. We are followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we believe in the risala and the message that came down from Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Yet at that time, very few people had accepted it. Look at how Allah gave acceptance thousands of years later. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidum majid. You are asking Allah's blessings and salutations and so on for Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the same way that he had blessed Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Wow. So that name is here. In salah, we say it. Those are the two friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Khalilain. They are known as the two friends, close friends, the highest level of friendship. Do you know all the prophets were not on one level? They were on different levels. تلك الرسل فضلنا بعضهم على بعض منهم من كلم الله ورفع بعضهم درجات. Allah says those messengers, not all of them on the same level. We raised some above others. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says some of them we spoke to them directly. Some of them were not spoken to directly but indirectly. Through Jibreel alayhi salam. Allah says that's obviously the choice of Allah. Allah spoke, subhanallah, to Musa alayhi salam, for example. Allah took Ibrahim alayhi salam as a close friend. All these are on different levels. The five of the highest of the messengers in level are known as Ulul Azmi min ar-Rusuli. They are those of great determination from among the messengers. Not to say the others were not determined, but these were tested more by Allah and they passed every single test and they would. The lesson is for you and I. When you are tested by Allah, take it as a sign of His love and friendship. Inna Allah idha ahabba 'abdan ibtala. When Allah loves His worshipper, He starts testing him. You find a person saying, "What's wrong? Maybe Allah's not listening to me. I am struggling from the beginning. When I was young, I struggled. When I grew up, I struggled. Now I'm old, I'm struggling. What's wrong?" Come on, man. Inna Allah idha ahabba 'abdan ibtala. It's a sign of the love of Allah. It all depends on your belief. How are you processing it? If you process it with the eyes of the material world, you will process it wrongly. But if you process it with the eyes of a believer and you take a page from those who were before you, who were loved by Allah, you will realize it's a gift of Allah. Subhanallah. So my brothers, my sisters, don't be upset. That is Allah testing you. He gives you one after the other. Allah Almighty says about those messengers, they were ulul azm. Fasbir. كَمَا صَبَرَ أُولُو الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ. Allah is telling Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, bear patience. Just like those who were known as ulul azm, those of determination from among the prophets before you, bore patience. So who were these five? Interesting to know. They are mentioned in the Quran in one place. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ مِيثَاقَهُمْ وَمِنْكَ وَمِنْ نُوحٍ وَإِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمَ وَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُمْ مِيثَاقًا غَلِيظًا. Allah mentions the names of Ulul Azm. Number one, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then who are the rest? Ibrahim alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, and Nuh alayhi salam. They went through a lot. They are mentioned in the Quran a lot. Musa alayhi salam's story is so much in the Quran. All of it was test upon test. First it was the Pharaoh, then it was this one, then that one, and Qarun, and the other one. So many different issues. But then there were good days as well. They were happy. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one thing that beats me, one thing that really, in fact, makes me think is when Aisha radiallahu anha says, "In kunna ala Muhammadin." You know, when she speaks about how they didn't have food in the blessed household, no food. For how long? If I told you, my brothers and sisters, there's not going to be water and food for the next few days, you would stock up and pile up, even if I was lying. Do you agree? Stock up and pile up. People said there's not going to be water. So you find all the drums from all the hardware shops are sold. Why? There was a rumor that there's not going to be water. Rumor! And we're already panicking. Aisha radiallahu anha says, 1 month passed, we had no food in the house. The second moon, we saw it, there was no food in the house. The third moon, we saw it, there was no food in the house. 3 months passed, we survived on water and dates. Yet we were the family of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What struggle did I go through, you go through? Zero, zero. None of us have ever had that in our lives. Not one. Not one. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Those are the friends of Allah. Allah says we took them as friends. Highest level of friendship. So in Surah Zukhruf, verse number 67, Allah uses that term. Khalil is singular. The plural is akhilla. Akhilla means those who are upon the highest level of friendship. Your bosom buddies, your closest chummies. Right? Allah says,
Al-akhillau yawma'idhin ba'duhum li-ba'din aduun illa al-muttaqeen.
Allah says, those who were the closest friends in this world, the best friends in this world, on the day of judgment, they will be the biggest enemies of one another. Look at your best friend today. Who is he? Who is she? Your best friends. Who are they? The circle. Allah promises you and I that those who are your best friends will be on the day of judgment your worst enemies. Ooh, I can't process that. I can't process that. My best friends will be my worst enemies. How? Imagine I've got friends who are my close friends. They know a lot about me. We help each other. But Allah makes an exception. So the verse is not finished there. Allah says, best friends in this world will be worst enemies on the day of judgment, except for those who are righteous. Those who reminded each other of their duty unto Allah. Those who were muttaqoon. Those who were conscious of Allah. Time of salah came, you looked at each other and said, let's pray. Then you're an exception. But time of salah came and you kept on doing what you were doing and no one reminded each other. On the day of judgment, you will say to each other, why did you do that to me? The other one will say, well, you did it to me. We didn't remind each other of goodness. You were sinning. You were on drugs and we did drugs together. You are both in trouble. You committed adultery and you knew about it, or someone knew about it and they didn't remind you. Hey, you know, a small tapping. Be conscious of Allah. One day you got to go back to Allah. Let's turn away from our bad habits and let's go into the good thing. No, we did not remind each other of good. We did not warn each other of the bad. So we are losers. That's why Allah says, were you best friends? You're going to be worst enemies unless you reminded each other of Allah. That's it. So who are your real best friends? Are they the ones who cheer you on? Cheer you on. You are doing haram. You are talking nonsense. You are intoxicated. You gamble. And they gamble with you and they intoxicate with you and they are happy with you and they cheer you on and you, that's it. That's my best friend. Why? Because you are doing the wrong thing together. That's why you're best friends. They say birds of a feather flock together. Well, these are vultures. That's what they are. Eating the carrion of the people. You backbite together. You slander together. You spread rumor together. Your best friends are those when you forward a message about another person that is negative, they reply to you to say, don't ever send this message to me again. That's your best friend. On the day of judgment, they will come and you will say, thank you so much. You saved me. I was about to fall into the pits of Jahannam and you saved me. Those are your best friends. Your best friends are those who tell you, I'm not going to talk to you because you did not come for salah. Those are your best buddies. Your best friend will say, because you were drinking alcohol, don't ever speak to me again. That's your best buddy. He cares for you, she cares for you. People care for you. That's why they correct you. They want you to improve. Your salah, your Quran, your dress code. If someone tells you, my beloved brother, don't dress this way, showing half of your backside because it's a trend. Not all trends will take you to Jannah. Most of them will take you in another direction. And you say, who are you? Look at your own dress first. Go see your children. Relax. The man's children and something else, pray for them. Maybe when you get an opportunity, you can talk about it. But for now, you were wrong and the fellow is telling you, please think about correcting yourself. Minimum, you should say, that's a friend of mine. He cares for me.
Al-akhillau yawma'idhin ba'duhum li ba'din aduun illa al-muttaqeen.
If I tell you the verse that follows from this, you will cry. You will weep because it brings tears to my eyes. Allah says your best friends will be your worst enemies except those who reminded you of Allah, those who were conscious of Allah. And then Allah says, I will personally call out to those who reminded each other of me. And I will say,
Ya ibadi la khawfun alaykumul yawma wa la antum tahzanun.
Oh my worshippers, on this day of judgment, there is no reason for you to fear, nor will you be sad. Don't be sad and don't be worried. You did the right thing. Who says this? Allah will personally say it to you and I, if we reminded each other about what was right and what was wrong because of Allah. Don't be shy. Speak in a good way. When I'm closer to you, I can speak to you in a more open manner. For example, someone is talking a load of rubbish. If he's your friend, as in acquaintance, or you know him well, you can tell him, hey, keep quiet. Don't you dare say that. And he'll still be okay because you're close to him. But if you're not close to him and you want to say, hey, shut up, he'll say, hey, you cause a fight. That's why be careful. When you're closer to someone, instead of overlooking their misbehavior, you should take it as your responsibility to correct it, even if it's not immediately. But in your heart, you need to feel this is wrong. And when I get a chance, I'm going to correct the sister regarding X, Y, and Z, or the brother. Don't feel bad when someone corrects you. One of the plots of shaitan is when you are wrong and someone corrects you, he makes you become angry and arrogant.
وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهَ أَخَذَتْهُ الْعِزَّةُ بِالْإِثْمِ فَحَسْبُهُ جَهَنَّمُ.
Allah says about the hypocrites that when you remind them about Allah and say, fear Allah, they become more arrogant upon their sin. Allah says for them, sufficient for them is hellfire. They don't want to be reminded. When a reminder comes to you, it's from Allah. And if you don't remind someone about right and wrong, you will be from among those who will regret having known the next person on the day of judgment. Imagine Allah himself is saying, Ya ibadi, O my slaves, O my worshippers, no fear on you. No need to be sad. You won't be sad and you won't be scared. Two things. What do you and I suffer from in this world? Sadness and fear. You become sad because of something and you're scared about something. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ. Allah says, مِنَ الْخَوْفِ. We will test you with a little bit of a few things. The first one he mentions is الْخَوْفِ, which means fear. You're scared, anxiety. What's going to happen tomorrow? I'm old, I might die. Relax. Resign to Allah. Leave your affairs to Allah. You're going to die? Alhamdulillah. Say, La ilaha illallah. Oh Allah, I'm returning to you. Have mercy on me. Become a better person. Seek forgiveness. The biggest gift you can ever give yourself is known as tawbah. That's it. The biggest gift you can give yourself is repentance. Turn back to Allah. Ask Him, oh Allah, forgive me. The biggest gift you can give yourself, obviously, with the changing of your life. You can't hold a bottle and say, oh Allah, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me. And you're gulping and gulping. That's not forgiveness. That's not returning to Allah. You need to stop it, right? May Allah make us strong, steadfast, be strong. My brothers, my sisters, you and I, no matter how old you are, we are returning to Allah later today. Did you hear what I said? We are returning to Allah later today. What that means is a few hours remaining. Subhanallah. A few hours remaining for you and I to go back to Allah. We want to be told, Ya ayyatuhan nafs al-mutma'innah, irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan mardiyah, fadkhuli fi ibadi, wadkhuli jannati. We want to be told and addressed as a beautiful soul that is calm. Oh, you calm soul, return to your maker. Happy and he is happy with you. Enter into the group of my worshippers, into my paradise. That's what I want to be told. That's what you want to be told. Believe in that. It's coming. Right now, while we are seated here, let's look into our hearts and promise Allah, oh Allah, I'm going to be a better person. I'm going to quit my bad ways, my bad habits for your sake, oh Allah. That's called preparing for meeting with Allah. Do that every day, every day. My brothers, my sisters, listen to what else Allah says. It doesn't just stop there. Ya ibadi, la khawfun alaykum al-yawma wa la antum tahzanun. Who were they? It's not so difficult to become from among the friends of Allah. Alladhina amanu bi ayatina wa kanu muslimin. Those who believed in my signs, in my verses, and they submitted unto my command. Kanu muslimin. They were submitters. When Allah speaks of the friends of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. Those who believe and they were righteous. Those are known as awliyaullah. Awliya is also a level of friendship where there is a protection from Allah for those people. That's called a waliyullah. Wilaya. Al-khulla. A khalil is a higher level than that. And wilaya is an extremely high level too. One is that of protection together with friendship. And the other one is that of friendship of an extremely high level, which automatically comes with that protection. Which one do you want? If you want the friendship of Allah, you must befriend good people. I always tell the youngsters, all of them young. Now we have to tell the old, and we also have to remind ourselves. The biggest favor that you can do yourself as a teenager growing up is to have a very good circle of friends. Very good circle of friends. That's it. Those who don't have bad habits, those who speak well, those who don't use bad words, they don't cause problems, they're not stealing and cheating, those who are not into unfortunate things. If you have a good circle of friends when you are young, your friends are good people, you will succeed in life, and if you die, you will go to Jannah. In the same group.
وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا.
Allah says, when the people of Jannah will go to Jannah, they will go to Jannah in the groups whom they were. Subhanallah. You go with your group. You're either going to Jannah or Jahannam. The next time you are with your group of friends and you're sitting and laughing, ask yourself, which way do you think we are going to go? You will know. It's easy to tell. Which way are you going? If there's good happening, inshallah, you go to Jannah. And if there's evil happening, you can see the same faces. One day there, you're going to see the same faces again. Because Allah also says, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِلَىٰ جَهَنَّمَ زُمَرًا. Those who disbelieved, who turned away, who transgressed, etc. When they go into hellfire or Jahannam, they will go also in their groups. Their groups. I want to be in a good group. Are you going to join us? Or are we going to join you? Are you good? If you are good, let's join each other. We want to go to Jannah. And when we go to Jannah, we'll go in our big group, inshallah. May Allah gather us in Jannatul Firdaus. So your best friends are those who correct you, those who tell you about Allah, those who remind you about your duty unto Allah, your salah, etc., etc. Those are your best friends. So Allah Almighty says,
ادخلوا الجنة أنتم وأزواجكم تحبرون.
The same people, Allah told them, don't fear, don't be sad. Then Allah says, they are the ones who believed in our signs and they submitted unto us. Allah says, you enter Jannah, you and your families, your spouses, you enter Jannah. You will be together in the group. Which group? My family. Why? Because if your family was also good, you deserve to be together in Jannatul Firdaus. Allah says, Udkhulul Jannata antum wa azwajukum. You enter Jannah, you and your spouses, your families. Enter Jannah together. Tuhbarun, you enjoy there. Full of delight, full of happiness. Be happy. And then Allah describes what you're going to get there.
يُطَافُ عَلَيْهِمْ بِصِحَافٍ مِّن ذَهَبٍ وَأَكْوَابٍ.
There will be servants all around serving you with plates made of gold and utensils such as cups, etc. made of gold serving you, and you're going to be there, mashallah. And how am I supposed to understand this? Allah says,
وَفِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِيهِ الْأَنفُسُ وَتَلَذُّ الْأَعْيُنُ.
In it, there will be that which is delightful. That which the soul desires and it's delightful to the eyes. Tasty to your eyes. Anything your eyes look at or want, it's yours. Subhanallah. Now, when you think of that, some of the youngsters are just looking at me, looking at me, looking at me. They are just imagining, I'm going to see this, it will be mine. I'm going to see that, it will be mine. I'll see that, it will be mine. I'll see that. So it will be finished from everybody else because it will all be mine. You see, you understand what I'm saying? I'm a human being. If Allah promises me anything you look at and you want, it is yours. I'm going to look at everything and I'm going to want all of it. Can it be all mine? The answer is yes. Allah says,
وَأَنْتُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ.
You will be there forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. And everything you ever want forever and ever will always be yours. That's what it is. And I want to end by telling you one thing. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Allah's ownership is so great that the creation of the skies, the heavens and the earth is bigger than the creation of man, but man doesn't know. Today when you catch a flight and you take off, after a little while you can't see anything. But in that little spot you're looking at, there are 20,000 people, each one thinking he or she is a big deal. They all got cars and houses and gold and silver and money and whatever else it may be. But right now where you are, you just went 30,000 feet above. You can't even see a thing. Allah says, you know what? If the whole of mankind from the beginning to the end had to ask me whatever they ever wished and wanted, and I gave every single one of them every single thing they ever wanted, it would not displace from my kingdom and my ownership, except when you put a needle into the ocean and take the needle out, what did it displace there? That is my kingdom. Allahu Akbar. Did you hear that? If you go into space like what they did recently and they took photos of the earth, the smallest planet is the earth. The other planets are very, very big. Allah says the worst person, the last one who will go into Jannah, will get whatever the size of the earth and everything it contains multiplied by 10 will only be for that person who's the last one to enter Jannah. Imagine if you were somewhere before the last. 10 times the whole world is only yours. Subhanallah. How small is this earth in connection or comparison to the kingdom of Allah? Allah says nothing. You dip a needle. One day when I was a little bit younger, I took a needle when I went to Durban. And I put, just to see, I was like a fool. Put in the water and take it out. Say, this is the hadith says, that's the amount of kingdom of Allah. It displaces, it was nothing. Subhanallah. When Allah gives everyone everything they ever want from the beginning to the end. La ilaha illallah. My brothers, my sisters, as I end, I tell you, develop your link with Allah. You have no option but to make friendship with Allah. Do your salah. Don't be lazy. Get up in the morning. Don't be lazy. A day will come when you will be happy all the way. Your problems may not deplete, but your connection with Allah will help you go through those problems. Your connection with Allah will help you smile in the face of adversity and difficulty and hardship. When someone tells you, how are you? And you know you are suffering with everything, you are just going to say, Alhamdulillah. What else? That is a friend of Allah. Are we ready? Are we ready, my brothers, my sisters? May Allah make us that way. May Allah truly make us Ibadur Rahman. That's the name of this masjid, by the way. And may Allah Almighty truly make us from among those whom He loves. It's not easy, but inshallah with His help, we will get there. Please have good friends, because we want to have the best of friends. And on top of that, you need to be the best friend of others. Remind them, be good, smile at them, you know, keep that connection, try and correct them. It doesn't mean if someone is going astray, you don't talk to them. No, you can remind them to keep coming. And Allah will help you and your children and your offspring and your friends. And Allah grant us all Jannatul Firdaus. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallam.